I just had to do that.
Yeah, Billy, you get in.
Where are we going for dinner?
We've only got a couple restaurants around the corner.
Can I hold the boom? I want to carry the mic. Can I carry it? You don't want me to? You don't trust me with your equipment?
What?
I want to carry the mic.
What are you looking at?
Why?
Kim?
Not me.
Uh-huh.
This is Puffy's old lady and she wants me to put her...
Oh my God! Oh good, you saved that.
Hey Mark, that's cool, I can hang on that thing.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Film him.
Hey. Where's the puff? Hey, where'd the puff go? We can't go anywhere without the puff.
Where's the drummer?
He's the man.
Oh, there he is.
There he is.
Look at this. We got a new tour manager, Bill. Good.
Matt!
Just pushing the new tour. And
this other tour manager, going to
fucking get drunk and fight.
Hey,
where is this joint?
What kind of food are we going to eat?
Fuck, not that guy, man. He was
need Mexican food.
I was afraid of him.
Too much coke.
No, he wasn't fat, but he had this weird hair. It's like crazy. It's like velvet. It's like a rug. It's crazy. He had this sick tattoo.
I like the motion of the camera crew. It's very good. It's very sneaky. Getting around. Just tight little spots. You're doing a good job. You get paid well?
How much do you pay?
Better than us, huh?
How much do you get paid, man? Tell me.
Go away! Get out of here! No pictures!
Hang on. Look to the right. Look to the left.
Okay.
Never told
me. Really? And it get like that if you never
told me? Through the hair.
Hey, you wanna see something funny? Watch this. See anything over here? Watch this. Isn't that great? You got a problem? Huh? You like people putting cameras in your face?
Hey man, you won!
Yeah, you hit him.
Alright, I'll shut up now.
You hit him. You win.
The cameraman hit my bass player.
Some friend you are, man. You just let him do it.
You can look at our backs for the rest of the day. How about that?
Talking about in our backs.
Just kidding.
I want you all to notice that we're all working hard and Puffy's lagging back there.
What's he doing back there? He's scamming.
I don't know, man. He's looking for free swag.
Ha 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 ha! Scamming.
Where are we going for dinner?
I don't know, man. Where are we going?
Straight all the way, so we can't walk no more.
Really? What kind of food is it?
Highway 9.
Highway 9.
Oh, got a little entourage coming. He's dropping shit.
Klutz. All of you guys are dropping stuff.
Are you guys klutzes? You guys nervous? Is that it?
They can't talk. I think they've been instructed.
Stay on the job.
Is it an unspoken law?
Is it
not to say anything?
Professional etiquette?
We're not on camera. You are.
Right.
Yeah, but you're a person. It's not just a fucking camera. Yeah,
it's kind of fun to
shatter. We're an audience. We're America.
It's kind of fun to shatter that illusion, don't you think?
Yeah. Hey. Behind the camera.
You guys are watching TV. We want you to talk back to us.
Come on. Tell us what you really think.
Talk back to the TV.
Call and response.
Yeah.
Call 1-900.
You hate us? That's fine.
Work with us. Yeah. Talk with us.
Communicate here.
Be one with the band on the road.
Yeah. I tell you, it's
not quite Puffy.
Why do you guys look like the Jets from West Side Story?
Good question.
Get back up.
Any of you kids out there, you know who John Gotti is? Suggest you read about it. It's good reading.
Hey, there you go, guys.
Oh, that would be good. Why don't you do a shot of you guys looking in the window?
There you go.
Hi. Wave to the camera. Hi. Hey, Bill's filming over there.
Go back.
Come on.
Look in the window. That misty eye look in your face, thinking of the future.
Come on, you know that look.
You just said, look. Work hard.
That's what it is.
You're not working.
That's green, man. We got the green.
Come on, that way.
Here, close
way.
Up on the car.
Yeah, look the car.
Hey, what are you doing, man? What's that? We don't want any of this.
Oh, fuck. You fucking faggot motherfucker. You want some of this?
Here.
Hey, you're after me.
Coming after you.
You're such a troublemaker.
Hey, film that.
Yes, film that. Hey, man, you wasted her only beer.
Film it.
They just bought a ticket.
What's the matter with her? She must not have a very good diet or something.
Oh, we didn't even go the right way.
What happened? Come on, follow me. We'll go back this way.
Oh, that's back where we started.
What? No, we're trying to go to this restaurant. Armin in a theater.
Oh. I think the Armin.
The BJ something saloon.
I haven't heard that.
Might be a good idea to go up the right.
I have 9 questions.
Hey man, they really love us, man.
See the way those ladies are driving with all those children in the car?
Those are our fans.
Did you drive with your children in the car?
I'm excited.
That lady must not care very much about her children. Or maybe she has other ones at home.
Hey, you know what? He got the girl was drinking a beer. I don't know if you could see on TV. And there was a baby in her lap with a bottle drinking juice. And he took the beer from her and smashed it on the street. No wonder she's mad.
I'm proud of myself.
The kid's just about speaking age, too. You know, think of the horrible words he's going to learn now.
Find my skateboard.
My marker. I want to get to the thing.
Hey, man, these are our fans.
Yeah, we are fans.
These are the people who buy my soup.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have him find his arm.
I don't know.
Sick.
Oh, wait, can you do something good for the camera? I mean,
what?
Really good?
What?
I don't know, sign like just a place where you'd never expect someone
like
to
where?
Sign.
All right,
come
to
on,
do
sit
back?
Down on my board and like, go like this,
here?
You know?
It can't be too obscene because this is MTV.
Okay. All right.
They're interested.
Go ahead.
And they say I'm a sick person, you know?
Yeah,
look
right?
at this. I should get them to sign my shorts, too. My mom's going to get mad.
You're happy about this, aren't you?
But that won't look good.
Yeah,
I'm not even going to sign it because it's so beautiful. I'm just going to print it.
Okay. Should be there forever now. Enjoy it.
You guys
take a picture
when
we go home.
That makes no sense.
There's no good restaurants around.
God damn.
What about the Radisson?
Thank you.
Isn't that open? Don't they have a restaurant in there?
Thanks.
Wait, hey.
See you guys.
Thanks.
See you.
Oh, look, we're leaving
what
everyone.
What is behind?
A tour of the town? Well, we got Alex's restaurant over here. Fine cats and dogs to eat. Basically, I think this is just like a crack town. I mean, just drug addicts driving around everywhere, drive-by shootings. Eazy-E's around the corner. We're going to go check him out a little later. He's hanging out with NWA, you know. I'm going to go fuck him up, you know. I'm going to beat his ass. See? Everyone wants to shoot us. I know, that's what I hear. Uzi Capital. Oh, look. Look at the sky. Pan up, for God's sake. Isn't it beautiful? For B, it stands for butt. It's the best letter in the whole world. It also stands for bungle.
It really doesn't matter.
That's really cool, man. Alright, thanks a lot, guy. Violent noise, dude. Look, free advertising.
See, look, lovely shirt. I haven't worn a shirt like this in X amount of years.
Okay, stay here.
Well, I don't have any sleeves, you see. I can't afford hair. It smells, too. Have some. So I'm covering this. I have to wear this shirt, you see, so we can have dinner here.
Yippee!
Which I guess is... Hi. I'm trying to put on this shirt. This is my wardrobe mistress.
I do very good wardrobe. You see, I have no sleeves either.
Trying to put this on. Bill's filming it.
Don't point at me, man. Don't point at me.
He's uncomfortable.
Don't point at me. No, you're trying to shrug off your responsibility.
No, not at all.
You are.
While I'm getting dressed, I'm merely pointing out what else is happening around us. Shall I roll up the sleeves?
Well, first you should button up.
I don't think I need to button it up, though.
You should cut the sleeves off your shirt.
Nice, yeah, we'll cut the sleeves
nice
off.
Place.
Of it.
You
that would
roll
be
it up.
Good.
Turn up your collar.
Turn up my collar, okay.
And they don't take sleeveless shirts around here. Yeah, there you go.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm trying to figure it out here.
Look, last time you wore a long sleeve button down shirt.
What does it look like? All right, I'm getting ready.
Just trying to remember. You have to excuse them.
Go like. Kind of like. This?
Help him out, Marilee.
I'm lost without my wardrobe mistress, I tell you.
You're embarrassing all of us.
Without my wardrobe mistress, I don't know what I would do.
Since
she's not around, I'm having to deal with this myself. Trying not to make a fool out of myself on national television.
Dude.
Oh, there's too many buttons. These must be the spares.
Dude.
These must be the spare buttons.
Rock? I never heard them, but what do you want to hear about them? What do they do?
They play music.
Okay, they play music. Okay. Ready? I'll give you my best Paul McCartney that I got, okay?
When I was with the Beatles, George Harrison was one of my best pals. But Faith No More was one of my favorite bands when I was growing up over in Liverpool. And well, I tell you, we were best of friends, and thank God Faith No More has made it, because I tell you, they gave me my inspiration. When I wrote Hey Jude, and I wrote it, Faith No More was the one that told me the words. Because we were out there together, and we were out there just playing and strumming our instruments, having a good time about it and all. And I tell you, they gave me the words, the inspiration. I wrote Hey Jude, and now I'm so happy to see that Faith No More made it. So all of Middle America, I want you to understand, Faith No More has it. And I want you to listen to their music and listen to the words and the music and the beat that goes with it, and get your feet together and let's go Faith No More, okay? Faith No More, let's go, all right? Have a good time now.
Thank you, Paul.
Okay, I'm rolling out, so I'll just go ahead.
I'm gonna go and warn them that we're coming.
Just open the door. Are we in the back?
Yeah,
all straight to them.
Hi.
Hey, everybody.
We're just having a nice dinner. It's nice you could all join us.
No pictures, please.
Just a nice romantic dinner outside, lights and cameras.
Yeah, life.
What should we have? What looks good?
The 1.5-pound lobster.
Oh, this is, you know, this was such a nice, quiet, elegant place to eat before your cameras and microphone came along. You know that?
Welcome to JD's backyard.
Wonderful.
Just have a little party here, don't mind us.
Hey, how come you guys don't play Huey Lewis videos anymore? I love this song.
Did you ask for it when they asked you what you wanted to play?
I didn't. I didn't think about it. I haven't heard it in so long.
Remember this video?
Nobody thinks about it.
That part of the band of a girl's butt shaking.
I used to love that.
Ho, ho.
I used to tape it and I'd rewind and watch it over and over.
Even when he talks, he's drinking whiskey and smoking cigarettes for about 30 years. Someone's on the street and gave him a demo tape.
No, like, oh, well, thank you.
The world's greatest publicist, Kim Cotton.
Okay.
She's from. I don't even know what the hell
they're talking about.
Get even, eat a shark.
That's the boss.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
What is the San Francisco?
Thank you.
Does the steak come with anything like potato or?
Yeah, all the entrees come with either baked potato, rice, or French fries.
I don't see any baked potato here. Could it be mashed?
How do you like the rock light? We'll be right back.
Thank you. Thank you. Hello.
Hi.
Hi there. How you doing, MTV?
Come on in to our living room.
Welcome to our home.
It's our fine home.
Plenty of room for everyone.
Indeed there is.
Mm-hmm. You better come look at the toilet.
Yeah, especially the toilet.
Don't throw any paper in the bowl.
You can't poop in it.
Do you just carry the battery pack?
Notice the pubic hair on the sides.
Notice the mirrors in here so you can watch yourself jack off. Now, for the porno lounge.
Also doubles as a matrimonial suite.
For the lovers.
This is where it all happens. As you can see, you have a mirror here so you can view yourself in action. And but as you can see, not much porno has been occurring back here lately because it's been a storage place for people's junk.
Very nice.
The refrigerator, complete with your, you know, beverages, sandwiches. There's even an ice machine in there, wine. And lots of storage space up here for your boots or whatever. Stereo, TV, VCR, and there's even artwork on the wall. Isn't that beautiful? Very comfortable, and this is where we live.
Just before you start.
Wait. This is not your shot, is it, Bennett?
I'll tell you.
Yes. Have you ever seen movies when the mic stand is in the shot?
Yeah.
Isn't that funny?
Light stand, boom.
This isn't in the shot.
I got the shadow in the mirror. Let's go back to where you were. There.
Logs?
Like right here?
Yeah.
How's that?
I don't see it.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, we're speeding.
You guys just came back from Europe. Did you have fun over there?
Yeah, it was great fun.
We had a lot of fun in Europe. So we played a couple festivals out there. And it was like, out there they have these things every year. They don't really have them so much in the States, but sometimes, like in Holland, I think it was about 400,000 people that came. So we're just looking over this giant sea of people. It's pretty wild.
I guess while you guys were over there,
it's kind of exciting to watch. I'm paying attention to Billboard magazine, something I've never done before.
Yeah, we got back from Europe about 4 days ago. So we're just kind of having people tell us that we've broken right now while we were in Europe. So we're like, oh yeah, it's kind of like something happened while you were asleep, you know, or while you were at the office, the milkman was having an affair with your wife, that kind of thing.
Everything's the same pretty much from where we stand though at this point. It's like, well, we're still on tour, still playing shows, still driving around. I don't know. I think the music's kind of different. People aren't really accustomed to the sound. It took them a little while to get used to it. It took a lot of touring, too. I think we realized when we put out the record that it was going to take a long time, so we were all set and ready to, you know, tour as long as it take.
Yeah, in like Europe and the UK, it didn't really take so long to come around. It came around maybe about 6 months ago out there, which was what we were planning on around here. It just, you know, sometimes just, you know, people's tastes, you know, when something's a little bit different, just takes them a little longer to settle in and people to get used to it, I guess.
But in Europe, it was kind of the same way. I mean, we had toured on this record probably 3 times before we got the success that we had over there.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, the first time we went over, the same thing. Small right. Clubs got bigger and bigger.
That's true.
Kind of touchy subject. I'm not really sure what the objection is.
Yeah,
is it exploitation of animals or is it the pain that the animal went through? I don't know.
Yeah, do those people ever mow their lawns? Or they just let it overgrown and let pests come in? because, you know, plants can feel pain, and when you cut the lawn, the parts of that plant do die. The fish got back in the water and is okay.
And, you know, people go swimming. I'm not sure how painful it is for the fish, but I can go swimming and hold my breath comfortably. Can't a fish get out of water for a little bit? So I'm not sure.
I even built some character.
But it's a beautiful image, isn't it? I mean, to me, it's like completely striking. And that's what we had in mind, you know, this kind of vision, I guess, you know, and we shouldn't compromise what we want to do because it's going to offend some people, I think.
It's kind of like our philosophy of life. You can't really put it into words, you have to show it in images, and that's a very big one right there.
Fish out of water is absolute, I mean, it's great. Great image. For me, it works. If you've got to bend the rules a little bit, go for it.
We shot the next video?
Yeah, we just shot it last week.
We have exploding fish in the next video.
Yeah, there's a lot of fish in it. They did some stuff with an X-ray machine that, like, I'm not really sure how it works, but it's gonna look kind of like skeletons playing instruments at some points.
Yeah.
It's a lot of explosions, a lot of, we play in kind of rooms where, like, things are happening in the room, like, stuff is oozing down the walls. It's a bloody sequence. It's gonna look, I think, kind of like a horror film.
We have this thing where, like, the past year, you know, we've been touring for about a year, and we like to terrorize each other and make fun of each other, pick on each other, and we had the opportunity to do it on film. And we got a hat, and everybody picked out a name, and whoever name they got, they had to dress and play the person's instrument. So in the video, there's some parts where we're playing each other, making fun of each other. So it should be pretty good. At least it'll be good for me to watch. Because we did a pretty good job of each other.
Absolutely.
Gremlins 2, and Surprise, You're Dead.
Yeah.
Right. I haven't seen it yet. I don't know. I never even saw Gremlins 1. I'm not sure what kind of movie it is.
I wouldn't have wanted it in any other movie.
Yeah.
Besides the Care Bears. And, you know, they had We Care a Lot. We never got any credit for that. Care Bears 2.
Did you know that? The Care Bears ripped us off and did
yeah.
We Care a Lot in their movie?
Yeah.
I swear to God.
Never heard from anything.
We should have sued him. It would have been a good publicity thing.
And it would
have
Faith No More
versus
things,
the Care Bears.
Would have put things to rights, really.
Headlines.
Because they really did rape us, and so to speak.
So they did an actual cover of the song?
Well, it was the same kind of riff, and then We Care a Lot.
It's
pretty crass.
Because it took us about 6 or 7 months after the fact to find that out, because none of us had seen the movie.
What you were at.
Yeah.
Okay,
cut tape just for a second.
Yeah, sure. Okay.
We're rolling.
I was just gonna say that, you know, the fish thing is a really strong image, and I think that's what bothers people the most, because the fish didn't really suffer for more than maybe 15 seconds.
Not even that long, because it was slow motion.
Yeah, right. I mean, it's funny that I think what it is it's a really powerful image, and I think that people are used to watching TV and seeing something that's, it's like candy to the eyes, and when something is a real powerful image, they freak out about it, and they don't expect it on the TV set. And I think that I think it's about time more powerful images start coming out. That's one thing that I think we're really into doing is, you know, getting an emotion and some kind of passion out of people, not somebody that's just going to eat their TV dinner and watch television. You know, it's got to be some participation there, otherwise TV can't be a good thing. Well, the thing that really bothers me is I think bands label themselves. I think that maybe we might have our own category of what we do, but the problem is, you know, if a band sees like a band like us doing well and we kind of have all these different kinds of music, they're going to start doing that so that maybe they can get a record deal or something. And when you get a lot of bands that are all trying to imitate something, you're creating a category that kind of gets stagnant, and that's really unfortunate. When what it should be is if we're creating our own category, that's giving somebody else an opportunity to create their own category too. And when there's a lot of people creating their own categories, music is interesting, people go out to shows more, and everybody kind of has a good time, you know? And it doesn't kind of drag the guys that started doing something down with them.
Well, yeah, I feel the same way. I mean, I understand that people need to do that to kind of like, you know, understand what bands are all about. You know, they'll say, oh, this band is a heavy metal band, this band is a, you know, and that's fine, but, you know, we've kind of, you know, avoided all that, and it's all for the better. That's probably one of the reasons why it took so long for this band, I think, to kind of, you know, achieve whatever success we've got today. It's because I think, you know, we're different. We're not really, don't fit into those categories, and it's taken a while, but same way, I think we probably have a lot more staying power.
I think a lot of reason people think of categories is because, say, this country is so large, just getting records to people and selling records, you kind of have to target your audience, and you have to think in categories, because, you know, it's business, and you know, try to sell records. Unfortunately, people that succumb to the categories also become victims of that categorization, so that they can't accept anything unless it falls into certain guidelines that somebody selling a record has given them. And I mean, there's nothing really the matter with it, because it's a really big country and there's a lot of people, and that's kind of, bureaucracy's kind of a necessity, but at the same time, it's good to realize that and know that, say, you know, when you read a rock magazine, it's because those bands in that magazine are targeting a rock audience. And it's good to know that, to take it kind of with a grain of salt, you know, and just take things as music and not categories too. Every category's got something good about it. That's why it does well and people like it. As long as you realize that that's just kind of, that things are segregated, kind of, I think a lot of it has to do with the business side of things.
Pretty much, yeah. We do a lot of press over there.
Also, they sort of create this controversy, What do you make of all that?
Yeah, that was kind of pushy of them, but I think it was just to, like, kind of, I mean, for their own benefit. I mean, a writer asked really pointed questions, you know, to kind of stir up a little controversy, just so, you know, he could get an article that probably people would talk about. It's not that big of a deal. I mean, we'll talk about it just for, you know, press for them, because they're our friends, you know, and they'll probably do the same for us, I figure. We'll just go back and forth doing each other favors, talking about each other, whether it's good or bad. Our name is mentioned, you know, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, we were thinking, actually, we had the idea of where we were going to meet with the Chili Peppers and go, okay, we want you guys to start slagging us off, and we're going to start slagging you off, and get this whole big war thing going for about maybe 3 or 4 months, in between our records, maybe. And then in about the next 3 or 4 months, the guy who benefits the most from the publicity will buy everybody dinner. And then it'll be over.
We haven't actually gotten together and talked to him about it yet, but that's what's going on. We've been slagging back and forth. I'm hoping they know what we're doing and we know what they're doing.
Tell me about the whole thing.
It's called You Fat Bastards, and it was filmed in England at Brixton Academy. It's 60 minutes long, live show.
Is there any other stuff on it?
No,
They were gonna do that, but after Soundcheck, we kind of all scattered off, and so they couldn't film us backstage, which is kind of good, really, because it's, us backstage is really no pretty sight or anything.
Yeah, there wasn't really a lot for them there, I don't think.
There weren't a whole lot of groupies, and drugs weren't happening that night, and it was just a slow night.
And also, it was just 60 minutes, and it was like, we cut songs out of our set that we wanted in the video anyway, so it's like, why do you want to see us walk around backstage? Is that really what you want to see? I'd rather have people seeing, you know,
what
the live
do.
Show, that's yeah. Kind of the thing.
We don't live the life.
Yeah. I wish we knew how, but...
Yeah, we try. We can't just do it, otherwise, you know...
Especially on film, it's even harder, you know?
We don't look good
like
in makeup
you're enjoying
either.
Yourself, and yeah.
Most people think their own thing, like, you know, like Bon Jovi's video or the like.
It probably is for them. It depends what your priorities are, I guess. We put out a really intense live show, so most of the day for me is just resting and getting ready for the show that night. I mean, just and reading, of course.
Of course, reading.
Of course.
Ronnie, what's the
role
like?
It's pretty comfortable right now. I mean, this is something new. We've got a bus and we've got people who do our, you know, set up our stuff for us. It's kind of a job. We've been at it for a really long time. It's just getting real habitual. The thing that keeps it interesting is, the show every night is always fun. That's good. Pretty much, I think, our road life revolves around the show. Australia, New Zealand, and then we're going back to,
We're having a 3-day vacation in Lucerne.
Yeah.
Switzerland.
We're gonna all take a vacation together.
We're doing a couple of festivals, yeah. Community vacation. We're all gonna hang out. We're getting one room, and we're all gonna sleep on the floor in sleeping bags and tell stories and
stuff.
Yeah,
a real slumber party sort of thing.
Yeah. Because, you know, it's always a work situation. You never get to spend time with each other, like, in a fraternal atmosphere, you know? Just like, Jim, you know, I really like just being with you, you know? Aside from the band, you know? Just you give me a good warm feeling inside. And so we're gonna kind of have some of that out. It's kind of like a marriage encounter.
I heard it was, but I guess he's starting when we're still over in England doing some shows. We already had shows booked. If we can work it out, I think we'll do it, yeah.
You think the Billy Idol crowd is ready for tonight?
I would think so, yeah. I'm ready for them.
Yeah.
Have you been writing any new songs?
Not a one.
No.
I mean, we all individually have stuff going on, but we haven't, like, sat down and worked anything out.
It's really hard to arrange things. That's pretty much what we all have the ideas. We just have to sit down and arrange them. That, you know, it takes an afternoon that we just don't have.
Yeah. So. It's something that we're all looking forward to. I mean, getting back home and writing songs is going to be great.
Yeah.
We've never had problems with that. It's going to be a real vacation to actually, like, sit around and go to the studio and write. That's great.
It's going to be fun. I mean, it's been a year of touring now, and so, I mean, when we get back, I know, you know, I keep saying I want a month off and not see anybody, but I know in a week I'm just going to want to start. I mean, it's going to be just an explosion of ideas, and everybody's going to have them. So that's why it's kind of good. It's good we're in a good position that we've been touring so long, because I know the next record's going to be really good because we're so excited about making it. And, you know, we've got so much in our heads, so it should be pretty cool.
I have a lot of questions about MTV News. What do you guys think of the controversy?
Yeah.
I've only got one problem with the Two Live Crew, and because I saw him on Donahue, the guy.
He's put that again.
Yeah. Well, that's really stupid, the bus, like, the record stores and all that, totally against that. The only complaint I have against the Two Live Crew is when I saw him on Donahue, he just kept interrupting everybody. That really bothered me. That was really rude of him.
But the light's blinking on the camera. What does that mean?
Oh, well.
Gen bunnies. Never heard of them.
Yeah. Celibate rifles.
Were they
popular?
Sex pistols.
How do you guys feel about warning stickers on albums?
I think in a way it probably helps the record sell.
Yeah, and it's good. I would hope that maybe the government could accept that as a compromise, because that's fine. Sure, as explicit lyrics, that's fine. Might as well tell people.
Yeah, people want to be informed.
They deserve the right to know, the consumer.
This is from a special that you did on the call, Sex and the Money. Who or what do you
invent? Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. They really get me off. Have you seen the movie?
Only Manuel Noriega is sexy to me. I find him extremely attractive.
So little.
We don't really have high standards or anything, you know. It's just a little things.
That man right there. See those red glasses?
Peeping over the Kilroy over there.
Now, this is for, we're going to have a favorite artist weekend on MTV, so let's do this separately. And do yourself and send, you know. favorite video where you can do my favorite band, so and so, why, and
of any band or whatever?
To the lens?
If you want to take a minute to think about it. No, it's okay.
Favorite video? Does it have to be a...
favorite video or favorite thing. You can start.
What's a cool video?
Yes. Okay, my favorite video by far is 911's A Joke by Public Enemy. And I got a couple favorite bands. One's The Young Gods, Sade, No Means No, and what was that other one? I don't remember anymore. Those are my favorites.
I'm not sure about a video. I think my favorite band is probably Young Gods too, because they're really innovative with their keyboards. Got a really good thing going. I like Fugazi a lot too, because they've got so much to say.
This is for a special that MTV is doing on drugs. What do you think of legalizing drugs?
I think it might be a good idea. Something we haven't tried yet. Maybe we should jump in with all fours and legalize drugs.
It's worth the experiment, you know? I mean, you could be wrong, but if you don't give it a shot, how are you ever going to know?
Yeah. They tried prohibition. It didn't work, and they revoked it.
And, you know, I'm really dismayed by the stance the government's taken the past years of equating soft drugs and hard drugs in the same category. It seems like there was a separation for a while where, you know, a lot of taxpayers' money is spent on, you know, marijuana and apprehending marijuana when it's something that hasn't even been proven really dangerous yet. And, you know, we're paying for that. You know, heroin is one thing, and I think they should probably spend more attention on that. It's a lot more socially destructive, and the organized crime elements are a lot more nasty. And I would hope that maybe people's definition of what kind of drugs the priority should really be stopped should be... this should be taken into account these days, because the way the government's lumping everything together, it's really not good.
Do you see any signs of racism in the music
scene? Either in songs or... I see a lot, actually. I see a lot of segregation in music, and and the biggest way is, it's good that Living Color and bands like that are getting, well, I mean, just saying that they're going to the target wide audience and they're being accepted, which is really cool, because I know it's been really, they've been having a hard time. But at the same time, a band like us that's got a lot of different influences, we're almost completely barred from a lot of black stations, urban stations that I think, you know, I listen to a lot of urban music, and I would like to think that, you know, we could get over there and play some shows and, you know, keep our audience with all kinds of people. And for some reason, there's a wall there, you know? And I'm not sure if that's anybody's fault, if we're being rejected or anything like that, but there's definitely a wall. You know, there's like two different crowds. There's the white crowd and the black crowd, and that's really unfortunate. It's kind of stupid.
I guess so. If racism is segregation, then I guess there is racism in music.
What could or should be?
I don't know. I think people should probably take more chances.
I think, too, it's kind of the industry's responsibility to try to start appealing to both races, you know, at the same time, and not just targeting a black audience or a white audience and kind of trying to blend it in a little bit, you know? Just because it's a safe bet that if you target somebody to a black audience, blacks will buy it, there's no excuse, because what you're doing is you're keeping a barrier there, really.
Right.
How's the
shot?
Yeah,
it's working.
We're speeding.
And I need your pull. You're going to have to go high.
Right
across
the middle. Oh.
You
guys just finished up with a
successful
tour in Europe.
Did you
have fun over there?
Yeah. We had fun over there.
Come around from the other side.
Okay.
This is
where the
morning
is. You know something? I think that guy, someone pointed this out to me last night. He doesn't have any hair, really. It's all attached to that bandana.
You ever seen him with it off?
Fuck no.
No.
Fuck no. Ever.
I think so. I think so. I think they're pinned onto the bandana.
Yeah, we had a good time there for once.
Europe was beautiful. The summer festivals are very, very enjoyable. It's quite a good time.
Outside in the fresh air, the sunshine, all the people.
Wildly drunk, all the humanity.
Gosh, Lenny Kravitz, man.
Beautiful. It's really, yeah, a lot of fun. It's a lot different than the sweaty places, you know, the outdoors. It's a lot of fun.
It was God's art.
I don't know what that means.
See that? That was swollen when it was infected. It's not infected anymore. Isn't that weird?
Totally.
Okay, totally. I have to ask you guys the
first totally
question again. Sorry.
What's the question?
Oh yeah.
It was great, man. We had a lot of fun there for once. The open air, the sunshine, all the people. We played some summer festivals there, and it was beautiful.
Great.
It was so much fun. We had so much fun in Europe. The open air, we played some summer festivals there.
We had so much fun in Europe. The open air, summer festivals.
It was
drunk
great.
People.
And Lenny Kravitz, too.
How does it feel to be big in the U.S. today?
Just like this. I don't know. What can I tell you? I mean, here we are all together. You're here, too.
Feeling of, it gives you a feeling of togetherness and
unity
community.
Within the universe.
It feels satisfying.
Mike?
Same question? I really need this job because it's real nice. It's satisfying. We've worked for a long time. We've been touring for a long time. And it's real good that people are picking up on it. So pick up on it.
Ditto.
It's great, man.
Okay, what do you...
Raw it.
We'll do the same thing, I guess, down the line.
We're all going to give the same answers.
What do you make of the animal rights up for competition?
It's cool. Everybody's got to do something. But, you know, I think that we should talk about a group that's been neglected. Very much. As a matter of fact, not many people even know about it. It's the Plants Rights Group.
Free the fern.
If you're not part of the solution, you're part of the problem.
That's right. Rescue the rose.
Does the fish come back in the next
week? It's resurrected and we
saying.
Cook it and we eat it.
I have a little surprise.
I don't know. Was there a big animal rights uproar?
No.
Really?
I don't know what for. I mean,
I think that's
it's
hype.
Just Martha Quinn.
The fish has the right to be filmed just like
hey,
anything else.
Wow. Yeah, the fish got paid good. There's no exploiting.
What happened to the
fish? I don't know. They put it in the bucket and we left.
I'm sure it's dead now. You know, fish spawn and they pretty much die after they do that. That's kind of their purpose in life. And I don't know if this one had spawned already, but I think it's safe to say that it's dead now.
It's got a lot of nightmarish things in it. Some crazy stuff. We had a lot of fun making it.
It's ultra violent.
Pretty weird stuff. There's some crazy stuff in it. It'll be very interesting. Some more fish and other things.
Some Mike. Ferns.
Mike, you dress up in it?
Yeah, I do. Yes. It's great. I'm a different person every few seconds. Yeah, what am I? I'm a clown. I'm a, that's one. I'm a surgeon with blood all over him. I'm a fat German in Lederhosen.
Cool Lederhosen.
And a bullfighter. Ooh, well, sort of a bullfighter, kind of. And, I was going to be a cook, but they didn't want me to be a cook. Five.
Best and part about the whole thing, though, is for one take, he was Roddy.
Oh, yeah, we switched.
I was him. He was Bill. Bill was you. Mm. mm-hmm. and Roddy was me, and it was beautiful.
They probably won't use it, but it made us feel a whole lot better.
That's right. Talking about doing all the things that each of us do when we play was fun.
Seeing as we're all jealous of each other, it was a very satisfying thing to be able to be each other for a second.
Just a second.
It was good to be someone that you hate.
You did a whole bunch of shit. You got painted blue?
Oh yeah, I got painted blue.
Hi.
You got painted blue?
I'm just kind of thinking about, trying to think of all the things. I got painted blue. Oh yeah, and I got that slime dumped all over me.
A lot of slime.
I was laying on my back and I opened this little door and all this slime drops out on me. Sounds kind of fun, but it wasn't because the stuff that they dropped on me, they didn't tell me that it hardens after a little while. And it hardened in my hair and I had pink dreadlocks.
It was the stuff they used to make dental molds, teeth molds.
Yeah, put it in your teeth.
Immediately dried up like that.
I look like Puffy.
While you guys were all burning, when the press sort of screwed up this thing, what do you guys think about that?
It's all true. We believe it.
Believe the hype.
Some people have, you know,
sent
you guys down a lot of lines. I don't
see that. Well, you know, we every few days we put on their records and practice to them, and I think we got it down pretty well.
I can't play and make faces, though, at the same time. I'm still working on it.
Tell me about the whole video you have coming up.
It's called You Fat Bastards. And it's a live performance. Brixton Academy, London. It's an hour long.
It's basically really boring. Don't buy it. Don't waste your money on it. Because, like, we wore all this makeup and spandex, and it's not really us in the video.
Sorry, we're playing to lip sync.
So don't get it.
Well, it is really like that, actually. It is just like that. It's just that in those videos, you know, of course they're not going to put in all the little things like brushing your teeth and going to the bathroom and spilling drinks on yourself on accident.
I didn't think guys like that did that.
Because they don't show it in the video.
I think it's more like Spinal Tap myself. It's, or maybe like waiting in line at the DMV or Taco Bell or something. That's what the road's like to me.
Mike, tell me about all the covers you've been doing.
I can barely hear you, sorry.
Tell me about all the cover tunes that you've been doing. Like
Yeah, we do Nestle's, the commercial, because it's white chocolate and it's beautiful. And we do a Commodore song called I'm Easy. And we gave up the Black Sabbath song. And I do like little bits and pieces of covers, and these guys don't even really know what they are. I just do it to make them look like idiots.
What's planned after you finish?
Mm-hmm. And how? Going to Australia? Australia? We're going to New Zealand? We're going back to Europe? We're going to England. And then there'll probably be some more American dates in the fall.
If the Billy Idol thing happens, Jen, do you think the Billy Idol crowd is ready for you?
Sure, why not?
Without a doubt. Indubitably.
What? I'm sorry, I was busy copying them. What'd you say?
If the Billy Idol tour happens,
yeah, I think that's great. I'd rather tour with Bill than Vince Neil and the crew.
Have you guys been writing any new songs?
Yeah, lots of new songs. We got lots and lots of new songs.
lying.
We haven't written any new songs. Too lazy. We're gonna need to take a nice, big, long vacation before we can write new songs. News questions?
Yeah, like questions not really about the
band. Oh, I see.
Current events.
Jim, have you heard about the controversies around the Two Life Group album and their obsession bus?
Haven't heard anything about it.
Have you guys?
Sure.
Yeah?
We'll help them sell records.
Yeah, really. It's a good tactic. Thinking about trying it.
They must have a better press agent than us.
We're actually supposed to play with them at one of those summer open-air festivals, but they didn't come because they're probably in jail somewhere.
Mike, how do you feel about wanting to stick with my mom?
Which Mike are you talking to? She was looking at me. It's a symptom of the, if they didn't have these people barking and screaming about what's inside a record, they wouldn't have to have the warning stickers. Let's hope it doesn't get any worse, you know, let's hope they don't put black, you know, plastic over the record so you can't see it like they do at 7-Eleven, you know, over the porno mags. I mean, I don't particularly think it's a very good thing that all this is happening.
I think it's all right because at 7-Eleven with the porno mags, when I see, like, the black thing over the cover, it's kind of exciting to me, because then I don't really know what I'm going to get, you know? It could be anything, and you get it, and it's kind of adds to the, orgasm.
Jim?
Well, everybody's got to do something, I guess. I don't know why they put the warning stickers on this, it's a strong language, but most kids who are old enough to go and buy records have heard all that before, you know? Most of their folks use that same language at home. They're talking on the phone to their buddy or whatever, they might slip out a little bit, you know. What's the big deal?
Indeed.
But, you know, everybody's got to do something, and these folks believe that they're doing a constructive service. And if they feel good about it, okay, whatever.
Yeah, it's a job. Someone's making money at it, that's cool.
But those stickers don't look very ozone-friendly to me.
Or plant-friendly.